everybody. Welcome back to Cinderella Phenomenon. When we left off, we had just been approached by a mysterious man that we haven't seen yet. For all I know, he's a Mad Hatter, you know, top hat wearing psychopath who is about to put a curse on me. It seems like that's where the story is heading, so let's jump right in and see what this man has to offer. Why the sour face so early in the morning, princess? Well, hello there, and how did you get in? And you're gonna do something terrible. Let me guess, it's the king, the queen, or Princess Emmeline? Or is it all of them? I ignore his question. Fritz, what are you doing here so early? Oh, so she knows him, okay. So he's not a top hat wearing psychopath. Maybe, I don't know. I'm running some errands for my father. Fritz Gerald Aiden Leverton, son of the highest knight of the Order of Caldera. Oh, son of a knight. His father, Sir Alcaster. All these names are like, I have to pause to make sure I'm saying them right, because some of them are kind of awkward. Has served the royal family for many years. Sir Alcaster is one of the king's most trusted advisors. 3 years ago, Fritz was assigned the honor of becoming my personal knight, and I bet you just sauce him morning, noon, and night. Just like, ugh, Fritz, stop following me. He's like, it's kind of my job. His presence is the only company I can tolerate nowadays. Oh, that's good. So she's nice to Fritz. You should wait in the throne room then. God, she still sounds so salty. Thank you. Was she like saying, well, why don't you just go wait in the throne room? And then he's like, oh, sure, thanks for the advice, but it just, I don't know. It's awkward. No, look at his sad face. Princess? Yes? You know, I haven't seen your smile once since I met you. Why is that of any importance? Jeez. Still, I do hope to see you smile one day, Princess. Luchette, you should be nicer to people. Well, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you at 10. 10? Don't tell me you've forgotten. Forgotten what? You're going to town today, remember? That must be where the curse happens, maybe? I deflate as the realization dawns upon me. It has been 2 days since the king issued the order. Luchette, I would like you to accompany Emmeline on one of her town outings. Surely you could send maids with her instead. I would not have requested you to accompany her if I was going to send her with her maids. God, Luchette, come on. I want you to make an effort to get along with your sister. Stepsister. She is your sister, and you will treat her and Rod as if they were of your blood. 2 days from now, you're going to accompany Emmeline outside. It has been 4 years since you last left the palace. Ever since then, you have locked yourself away. You barely leave your room. Angiel was in the grip of war back then, but now the kingdom is safe and back to its former glory. I want you to see how beautiful Angiel really is. Luchette, a princess must know her kingdom. Go with Emmeline, and she will show you the town that you only ever see through your windows. Is that an order? If it needs to be. Poor Gennaro. Are we clear? Luchette? Understood. The last time I left the palace was 4 years ago when the king took me with him to check on the people after the Great War had ended. I shake my head, removing myself from the memory. I am safe here. Princess, are you all right? It won't be that bad. The townsfolk are good people. How can you be so sure? Times have changed. People change. This is precisely the problem. Mother never changed. Mother loved me until the end. I'm pretty sure that your dad and your stepmom and your step-siblings and, Mr. Fritzy Fritz here probably all love you. You're just being a little bitch. Sometimes changes for the better, princess. I think you'll see that today. If you'll excuse me, I shall see you later. Ah. Delora. Do you think witches are capable of bringing back the dead? That sounds like a bad idea, Luchette. No necromancy in this kingdom. I'm all for it, but I don't think you're very good at it. I wish you could talk to me, you and the others. My dolls are my only friends. They are the only ones I can trust. Unlike humans, they will never betray me. They will never hurt me. They will always be there for me. The moment I saw Delora, I knew she was special. She's probably a witch or a fairy in disguise, and something is gonna happen. I keep, like, trying to guess what's gonna happen. She was different, so elegant and realistic. It was almost as if she was breathing. I would have immediately, like, thrown that doll away. Like, Dad, I think my doll is breathing. I think she just blinked at me. And now she's smiling. Can we just toss her in the incinerator? I don't need a ghost doll in my room. She was a gift from the king on my 17th birthday. Okay, so Luchette is definitely an adult, and she's acting like a 5-year-old. I only started receiving dolls from him when Mother passed away. Mother does not believe in birthday celebrations. Jeez. But every year at midnight, a letter would appear under my door. It would contain instructions leading me through the palace on an adventure to a room filled with gifts, cakes, and sweets. A child's dream. I'd been fascinated by the dolls, which had always held a little greeting card. A card with the words, "I love you," on it, signed by M. The card would tell me to keep those celebrations a special secret, but I didn't need to be told that. Mother always found a way to show me she still cared. In her own way. The secret celebrations had stopped as soon as she had disappeared. So did she just, like, vanish? Did she not die? Yes? Excuse me, Your Highness. The King has requested your presence. This better not be another lecture. Tell him I am on my way. I will see you later, Delora. I don't like that doll. Oh. Good morning, Your Highness. It's another man. Oh no. Luchette's like, you're not Fritz. Sir Mithros, the royal advisor. Father trusts him a great deal, just like he does Sir Alcaster. So, it's weird that her dad has all these good-looking dudes just hanging around the castle. I mean, it's weird, right? Every day you look more and more like your mother. He said creepily. I sometimes find Sir Mithros talking to Mother's portrait when he thinks no one is looking. Okay, so her mom either disappeared and went back to Witchland, and the picture's like a conduit, or this guy, Sir Mithros, was in love with her. Or he's a witch too. Or her mom in disguise, I don't know. He must have admired her a lot, but I cannot bring myself to think highly of him. There is something about him that puts me on edge. Are you on your way to see the king? I shall not keep you then. Until our next meeting, dear princess. Luchette is just so snotty with everybody. Your Majesty. Luchette, are you ready? You will enjoy this, Luchette. I've heard the toy shop has lovely dolls. At least he's trying. This will be good for you. You will get to know your sister better, and you will be able to interact with and learn about the people of Angiel, about our subjects. I will not learn anything I do not already know. Why do you always believe that the people around you are incapable of good? Because I have seen how quickly people will betray and manipulate each other to get what they want. Mother warned me about human nature. You do not see clearly, Luchette. If you would only open your eyes, you would be able to see how good people really are. I believe I am already quite capable of seeing the true nature of people. After all, I have seen that there is no good in you. Jesus, Luchette. God, I just want to, like, jump in this game and just, like, just punch her right in the freaking jaw. She's so mean. Luchette, where were you when I needed you 4 years ago? Where have you been ever since? Back then, I'd been overflowing with grief and pain. I'd just lost my mother, my entire world. I had hoped that maybe then he would have shown me love and compassion, even just a hug to let me know someone was there. It had been a childish hope. I had been left alone. I did not see him for months, had barely even heard his voice. You cannot rely on anyone but yourself. You cannot trust anyone but yourself. This is what you have taught me. Your Majesty. See, I understand her being mad at him, like, being negligent after that, but she never really thought about how he must have felt when his wife just disappeared. I mean, she was just gone all of a sudden. So, I mean, they're both kind of selfish, but at least he's trying to, like, make up for it, and she's not even giving him a chance. I know that I've hurt you. I know that there is nothing I can do to atone for what I did. But please, Ophelia and her children are not a part of that. They do not deserve to be hated. In the end, they still matter more to him than I ever did. Luchette. Enough. I've already said I will go. Everyone is waiting outside. I shudder at the thought of leaving the palace after so many years. Luchette, it will be okay. How can you be so sure? Thank you for agreeing to accompany Emmeline. I would not disobey an order from the king. Excuse me.
Oh, whoa, that was a fast transition to the toy store. Alright, girl.
Hello, how can I help?
You can help me by telling everyone that we're going to be stopping the video here. And we'll get back to the toy store tomorrow. So, I hope that you guys are enjoying Cinderella Phenomenon. I know I am. I really, really don't like Luchette. Usually I'm cheering on, like, the main character. Like, yes, you can do it. You're awesome. You're so cool. Go punch that werewolf in the face. But, like, with Luchette, I just want to, like, just slap the crap out of her. Like, come on, girl. You need to freaking grow up. I mean, that doll she was talking about, she got when she was 17. So she's probably, what, 19 now? 20, maybe? Something like that? I don't know. But I just don't like her. It's like the first protagonist that I just outright, like, I don't want to play as you anymore. Can I just play as Fritz or your dad or something? But I'm sure that she'll get better as the story progresses when she, you know, loses her princessiness and she has no choice but to struggle. You know, we'll see what happens. Yeah. Next is some Doki Doki Literature Club, so that should be cool. I don't know when it's supposed to pick up, but hopefully it does soon, and we see some, you know, horrifying garbage, you know? My poor main character is going to be traumatized for life, I'm sure, but I love you guys, and thank you for watching Cinderella Phenomenon and going on this little journey with me. So I will see you guys tomorrow for another episode. Bye!